WEEP's Scenario Explorer presents a high-level overview of your model. Think of it as a dashboard with controls and gauges where you can control key model inputs and instantly see how those changes affect the results. The Scenario Explorer is divided into two sections, data and results. When you first go to the Scenario Explorer view, WEEP will automatically display a few major results, such as supply requirement and unmet demand. Here we can see how unmet demands are increasing over time in several scenarios, while groundwater is being depleted in all but the integrated measure scenario. I'll remove the charts for supply requirement and inflows to area, so we can focus on the problems of unmet demand and groundwater depletion. In order to understand the differences among the scenarios that has led to these different outcomes, let's display a few major input variables. Initially, the data section is hidden. I will show it now by clicking on the Show Data Variables button. The Data section displays values for selected variables and selected scenarios from the data view in a grid with variables across the columns and scenarios down the rows. In this sample Weeping River Basin dataset, the demand measure scenario pushes for increased water use efficiency. The supply measure scenario builds a new reservoir, and the integrated measure scenario combines both these demand and supply measures. Therefore, let's show the data variables that define these measures so that we can compare them. First, we'll add the key assumption for efficiency improvements. It ranges from 0% to a maximum of 6%, with an increment of 0.25. Next, we'll add the data variable for the startup year for the reservoir on the Weeping River, the North Reservoir. Here we can see the efficiency improvement is an annual 2% increase in reference and supply measures, but 3.5% increase in demand and integrated measures scenarios. Similarly, we can see that the startup year for the North Reservoir is in 2003 for supply measures and integrated measures, and not active at all in the reference and demand measures scenarios. In addition to making clear the relationship between data and results, the Scenario Explorer can help us create new scenarios and explore how changes in inputs affect the outputs. Let's do a quick sensitivity analysis on the size of the new reservoir. For example, we might wonder if a smaller reservoir in the integrated measure scenario, in conjunction with the annual additional efficiency improvements, still meets all demands and stops the declining groundwater. For this, we'll show the data variable for the storage capacity for the North Reservoir. Ranges from 0 to 2,000 million cubic meters, increment to 50. Next, we'll add a new scenario to represent the smaller reservoir. It's called smaller reservoir. As we add the new scenario, we will automatically calculate this new scenario and display the results in the graphs below. Let's hide the other scenario so we can focus on the changes that we'll make. We'll hide reference, supply measures, and demand measures. Now let's experiment with changing the size of the reservoir in this new scenario. We'll make the reservoir half the size. In the integrated measures, it's 1,000 million cubic meters, so reduce that to 500. We will recalculate with this new value and show it in the charts below. Here we can see unmet demand is still zero in the later years of this 10-year time horizon. We can switch to the annual total so it's a little clearer to see. So this shows that even with a smaller reservoir, half the size, we still have achieved the objective of eliminating unmet demands while still stopping the decrease in groundwater storage.